Hey everybody, it's Dan Cheney. Time for another Music Charts Archive show here on DJNTV. You know, this week we're going to look at slow climbers. Specifically, we're going to look at songs from the 2000s, the aughts decade, that took the longest time to reach number one. A solid six songs on the list were the first single ever by the artist, and several have themes of broken relationships. There's rap songs, a country song, ballads, pop, and some mainstream rock. So hang on and we'll check out 10 songs that took their time to reach the pinnacle on this week's edition of the Music Charts Archive Show.
DJ Event Planner will change the way you manage and run your business. Streamline all of your procedures and software into one easy-to-manage system. DJ Event Planner, the ultimate online planning tool.
Welcome to this week's Music Charts Archive Show. I'm Dan Cheney, and this week we're counting down singles from the aughts that took the longest time to reach number one. So let's start the chart. Number 10 is Laffy Taffy by D4L. Hip-hop group D4L, which stands for Down for Life, had one top 40 hit, and this was it. It debuted on the chart on October 1st, 2005, and went on to hit number one for a single week 16 weeks later on January 14th, 2006. Rapper Shawty Low, who self-funded the group initially, died in a car accident in 2016. Rapper Liam Smack Eyes Thomas claims that the group stole the lyrics for Laffy Taffy from his rhyme book. At number nine, we have Hey There Delilah by the Plain White Tees. This was actually the second charting single for the band from Illinois, but their first top 40 hit, and obviously their first number one. It debuted on April 14th of 2007 and hit number one 16 weeks later on July 28th, and it stayed at the top for a couple weeks. Singer and songwriter Tom Higginson wrote the song after meeting Delilah DiCrescenzo, a steeplechase runner. They never had a relationship, but she did attend the Grammys with Higginson when this song was nominated for Song of the Year, which it lost to Amy Winehouse. At number eight, How You Remind Me by Nickelback. The first chart single for the band Nickelback was by far their biggest. It debuted on September 8th of 2001 and hit number one 16 weeks later and stayed at the top for 4 weeks. It ended up spending nearly a year on the chart. How You Remind Me was from their album Silver Side Up and ended up being the best-selling rock song of the decade and the most played song on radio for the decade. Singer Chad Kroeger said he wrote the song about his old girlfriend Jody, with whom he had a dysfunctional relationship. Number seven on the list, James Blunt with You're Beautiful. English singer James Blunt charted five singles in the U.S. You're Beautiful was his first and only one to crack the top 40. It debuted on November 12, 2005 and eventually hit number one for 1 week 18 weeks later in March of 2006. On the surface, the song may seem romantic, but Blunt says it's actually kind of miserable. He says it was about seeing his ex-girlfriend with a new guy who he didn't know even existed. He and his old girlfriend kind of caught eyes, but didn't say anything. Back at home, Blunt wrote the lyrics in about 2 minutes, he says. Number six, Big Girls Don't Cry by Fergie. Fergie's big solo album, The Duchess, produced five top five hits and three number one singles, including this song. It was the fourth single from the album and debuted on the charts on May 5th, 2007. 19 weeks later, and after 14 weeks in the top 10, it hit number one on September 8th, 2007. Fergie co-wrote the song with Toby Gad, who also co-wrote the All of Me song by John Legend, another slow rising number hit song for the next decade. When this song became the third number one from her album, Fergie became the first woman since Christina Aguilera in 2000 to have three number ones from a single album. Welcome back to this week's show. On this week's show, we're looking at the top 10 slowest climbing songs from the aughts to reach number one. So let's look at the top five slowest. Number five, we have Outkast and The Way You Move. Outkast's album Speaker Box / The Love Below basically had two simultaneous hits. This one was the first to make the charts, and it debuted on September 27th of 2003. Then 3 weeks later, Hey Ya hit the charts. Hey Ya hit number one, while The Way You Move waited patiently at number two for 8 weeks before hitting the top itself. It patiently waited a grand total of 21 weeks on the chart and hit number one on February 14th, 2004. The Way You Move was a big boy song for Outkast, while Hey Ya was an Andre 3000 song. The Way You Move features vocals from Sleepy Brown. Number four, Just Dance by Lady Gaga. Just Dance was the very first chart single for Lady Gaga, debuting on August 16th, 2008. 22 weeks later, on January 17th, 2009, it hit number one. 2009 became a breakout year for Gaga, who had five more top 10 hits coming for her that year. Just Dance features additional vocals by Colby O'Donis and was written by Gaga along with Akon and producer Red One. Gaga said of the song Just Dance, "That record saved my life," she said. "I was so depressed, always in a bar. I got on a plane to LA to do my music and was given one shot to write the song that would change my life." At number three is Everything You Want by Vertical Horizon. This alt-rock band formed in 1991 at George Washington University. Their first major label album was also called Everything You Want and was released in June of 1999. The song Everything You Want debuted on the charts right at the beginning of the decade on January 22nd, 2000. And 26 weeks later, a half a year, it hit number one on July 15th. Lead vocalist and songwriter Matt Scannell said he was in love with a broken girl who looked to everyone else except to him for love and acceptance. And that was the basis for this song. Number two, With Arms Wide Open by Creed. Creed's second studio album, Human Clay, debuted at number one in October of 1999. The song With Arms Wide Open took a little bit longer than that to reach the top. In fact, it was actually the second single from the album. The song Higher was the first. With Arms Wide Open debuted on May 13th, 2000, and 27 weeks later, on November 11th, it hit number one. The song was written by band members Scott Stapp and Mark Tremonti. Stapp wrote the lyrics upon finding out that he was going to be a father. With Arms Wide Open was nominated for two Grammy Awards, Best Rock Song, which it won, and Best Rock Vocal Performance by Duo or Group, which it did not win. And the song that took the longest to reach number one in the first 10 years of the 2000s was Amazed by Lone Star. Country band Lone Star had 9 number one songs on the country chart and had 17 songs cross over to the pop chart. But this was their only top 10 pop hit. It actually had two different chart runs. It charted from June to October of 1999 and peaked at number 24. It was remixed and then re-entered the chart in December. After a grand total of 31 weeks on the chart, it hit number one on March 4th of 2000. It would spend a grand total of 55 weeks on the chart. From the album Lonely Grill, it spent 8 weeks at number one on the country chart and was the first country song since Islands in the Stream to hit number one on the pop charts. Well, there you have it. Those are the 10 slowest rising number one songs in the decade of the aughts. What's your favorite? Let me know in the comments. I think for me, it's probably Everything You Want by Vertical Horizon. This has been Dan Cheney for the Music Charts Archive Show. And be sure to join me again next time for another top 10 list right here on DJNTV.